me again. So today we'll see how to print bridges and crowns. So first, let's prepare the print with Alpha 3D, our Nestic software. So first, we can check the settings. So we use Dentic, and we're gonna use for crowns and bridges CURO Temp A2. So for the resolution, I prefer to choose 50 since it's a delicate application. Okay, so now we can upload the file. First, let's take crown. So I can see the layout is okay. Then I can change the orientation. The most important part here is this part, because it's the one we'll go into the mouth. So we want to change the orientation. So now the less important part, face the big platform, so I can now go to support. So for this application, so we know it's a crown. So I choose crowns application. It will directly give me the pre-settings. Then I just have to click on auto support. And it will give me the good supports for this application. Okay, so now I will upload a bridge. So again, first we check the layout. So it's inside the build area. Then what is the most important part? So again, this is the most important part because it will go to the mouth. So I will change the orientation. Okay. I will add support. So what is the application? It's bridge. So again, I have all my pre-settings. Then I will click on auto support. And I will have all my supports ready. So it's very fast, very easy. Now I can just check all my parameters, change my project name. And save it. Now we have the slicing, and after the slicing I will have again my i3dp file and my ibf file, which is my project file and my print file. Okay, so now you can see here in my project file, here in my print file. So as I said before, now we have our project file and my print file. So I will copy paste my print file to my USB folder here. Then I will move my USB and plug it to the printer. So since it's a crowns and bridges application, so we use CURO Temp A2. So like last time, we'll have to shake it. So again, you can shake it for 1 minute at least. And after, when it's done, you can pour the resin inside the vat. So I just pour the resin inside the vat. So now to print with USB, you just go to print, then you make sure you have USB. Then you choose your IBF file, next, print, yes, and here we go. Print is ready. Let's clean it first. You can use 3 minutes, should be enough. It's cleaned. We remove all the resin so we can cut it off. Again, it's quite easy. So now it's off. I can blow it to remove all the alcohol. So now it's the final step. So we can use the Ackuretta oven to post-curing the sample. So just put inside the samples, and then we first post-cure it 2 minutes on the bottom. Now post-curing is finished. So remember, for the curing time, you can find it on our website, ackuretta.com. You can just click on the CURO resin you need, and it will show you all the curing time. So, as you can see, you just now need to cut the supports, polish it, and you're good to go.